Greetings, Earth enthusiasts. If you ever wondered about the incredible perspectives our planet has to offer from high above here in the right place, I am Dr. Clive Coetzee, and I'm thrilled to be your guide on this captivating journey into the world of remote sensing. Welcome. And please remember to like, subscribe to, and share this video. Thank you.
Yesterday, we started with a short little journey working on the Harmonized Global Nighttime Light data set. And as the authors put it, they're trying to harmonize the OLS DMPS data set and the VIRS data set. They're trying to create one internally consistent data set from 1992 till 2021. Within this video tutorial, I elaborated a little bit on the problems and the difficulties of these two, that they actually are incompatible, the two data sets, because the sensors are fundamentally different. VIRS are much more sophisticated sensor in measuring nighttime lights than the old OLS DMPS system. But nonetheless, and I said, you know, it's quite sad, it's quite a pity that it is that case, but, you know, so be it. I mean, the authors then within this article try to harmonize the two data sets so that we have an internally consistent data set from 1992 till 2021, which is a novel idea. And I'm just trying to do for 2022, 23, and 24 for present. So this is what we're trying to do at the moment. And here is basically the script, the code. Remember, I went through this, why I have different visualization parameters, the images that we've created, etc., etc. And just to recap quickly, you'll see that there is the 1992 nighttime light profile of my region of interest, focusing predominantly on these two towns, which is Piketberg and Veldhoven. So that is their profile in 1992. That's their profile in 1993. The profile, and then I did the 1994 profile. Should load now. Let's hope there. Okay, so there is it, the 1994 profile. And the idea is that the 2014-23 profiles should be as close as possible to make sure, you know, that it's internal consistent. There's 2021. And then there is 2024. Now you'll see my 2024 is very different. It detects additional locations of nighttime lights, which were not present in 2021. It's not that these places were non-existing in 2021. So that's a bit of an issue that we need to look at. It's that they're not being displayed in 2021. So they're not being displayed, but they were there. So whether they are excluded, we will have to have a look. And then, as I said, the big issue, the other issue in 2021 is that the resolution, you can see the difference in spatial resolution. Okay, so now the question is, obviously, so we assume now that this is our base value, which is 2092. So let's have a look and see here. If we change the values here. Now, there's two places. If I change the values here, so let's make it 3. The value there, and let's make it the upper limit, which is 63. Or let's make it 65. It's actually 63, but let's make it 65. And then we have to, within the script, say we're going to go value 3. So that means values less than 3 will be masked within black. Okay, so let's run it again. And see, so just make a little note. Let's make it a little bit. Hey, don't know why the computer is lagging a bit. So let's quickly just make a mental note of the nighttime profile when we had 10. And remember, we had this color scheme of 10 and 50. So this is the color scheme of 10 and 50, or the color scheme, the visualization parameter. So let's, if we run it again. So let's just go up, make it like that. And let's just unselect these. You see, you can see it's very different now. With that change in the minimum max, you can see that it does detect these other locations. It does detect these other locations. So let's start then, so which I think is important, but you can see the blooming effect. You can see how far this goes up. So now let's see if we now selected 2013, you'll see these other locations disappear. And you can see if we do 2013, you can see all these lights disappear. Which means that the two, it's not that the town shrink, because if you assume that this is because of the nighttime lights itself, it's not because of sensor or issues or because of visualization parameters, then you would think that these lights went off in these towns, that these towns disappeared, etc., which is obviously not the case. So if we start from this picture or this image, then obviously now we have to make sure that our follow-up, the 2013, is a continuation. These two must be internally consistent then. So we cannot have this now. So now we have to change this. So we have to make this also 3, and we make this 65. Okay, so let's quickly run this now and see what this looks like. So now it's a matter of adjusting these numbers so to make sure that there's a logic behind them. And the difference is not because of exogenous factors, but because of the nighttime light profile itself. See, so that's, so let's quickly have a look and see. So that is then 1992, and that is 2013. You can see again, 1992, it's all these locations included. You see there's all of these locations included. But if you go to 2013, you'll see that some of these are missing. It looks like there's definitely a decrease in the size in the area of lights. But in general, it doesn't look too bad. So what I'm going to try to do is I want to decrease the 1992. I want to minimize these effects. So if we do this, for example, 5, and let's run it again, and let's do this. Okay, let's do this, and we're gonna see it doesn't. Okay, so sorry, I must do. Let's go back there. Come on. Once we do the change here, we must also go and do the change here, which I didn't do. So that's 3. So we must change that 2013 there in 3 as well. So we didn't do that. My apologies. Must remember, if we change it, if we change the parameters, the minimax, we must also change the masking. So let's quickly do this again. Okay, so there we can have a look and see. Now it looks internally consistent. So there is the 1992. And there's the 2013. You'll see the two looks internally consistent. Because it expands and from the core, from the 1992. So it expands outwards and the core becomes more... or the colors represent higher nighttime light intensity. This is what one would expect to happen of a growing town. So this is what one would expect to happen from a growing town. Okay, now, so let's say 2014. If you can put down 2014, you can see the two is not internally. So the core seems to be fine with 2014, but you can see the surrounding area is now excluded. So now what we need to do is we need to do 2014 as well. So that means 2014, we might need to make that 3 as well there. So we make that 3, so 2014, which is the, 2014, so that's the first VS one. So that would be this, so let's make that 3 as well, and make that 65 as well. So that would be then for 2014. Okay, so let's run it again and see how they compare. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to make the profile internally consistent so that the changes that happens is because of the lights themselves, not because of the sensor change or this or that or this or that. So that's what we're really trying to do here. So let's do 2099. So we're going to look, see if this 2014 and 2014 map. Yes, I don't know why it's so slow again. It was just working fine. But anyway, it's very, very slow. So, and it's not that big a work anyway. So let's have a look and see. So why is that happening? So why is 2014 nothing happening? So that's 2013. So 2014 is now, oh, it's 655. Run. So that's a problem. These things are very sensitive to these numbers, so please take care of them. Okay, so let's delete that one and that one. So now we're building up. You can see now how this blooming effect, you can see this doesn't make much sense because now, okay, so come on. Okay, you see now all of a sudden all these places pops up. Now that makes no sense. This could be a light here. So if you take 14, you take that away, but have a look at the difference then. So there's no way this could be an actual number here. So 14, we need to. So if we stand on these values there, you'll see it's 0, 0, and then the reverse is 2014. So 0, 0, and all of a sudden it's 6. That makes from 2013 to 2014 an increase of 6. Now that makes absolute no sense. So if we stand in the middle, you'll see it was 10, 37, 38. So that sort of makes sense. That 2013 and 2014 values should be identical or very close to one another. So that makes sense. But these numbers here makes absolutely no sense. So in fact, what we then need to do is to say, let's make that a value of 10. And then I need to increase this value. The 2014 value we need to make here 10 for masking out. So let's run it again. I hope you guys are starting to see what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to harmonize these images using the visualization parameters, the minimum maximum numbers. And it's all trying to for these things to be internal consistent that there's a natural progression one way or another. Okay, so let's have a look and see. So with the new 2014, these things are gone. Okay. So these things are gone. So let's have a look and see visually. That's 2013 and that's 2014. So that sort of makes sense that these locations, that's 13. So you see now 14, these locations disappear. So that means my 10 here, my minimum value of 10 is too high because now the 2014 should roughly be the same. Image as 20, the 2014 should be roughly the same as 2013. So there's 2013. So if I do this, let's have a look and see. You see there, 2014 is less, it's not that much. So maybe it's not that bad. Although I don't think that there was a decrease. So maybe this should become rather 8. So now let's make that 8 rather than 10 and see what that looks like. Let's do that and see what the image looks like now. Because remember, we want to make 14 and 13 as close as possible. They almost have to be exactly the same for this thing to be internally consistent. Because remember, the old OLS system ran till 2013, and the new VR system started from 2013, 2014. So therefore, we need to harmonize. If you want to harmonize the two systems, you might need to make sure that 2013 and 2014 is almost the same thing. See, that doesn't make too much of a sense. So what we may have to do is to, okay. So if we're going to dig, so now we're working under 2014. We're leaving 2013 out. So if we're going to work on 2013, then we have to work on 1992 as well. So let's leave that for now. So now let's have a look at 2021. See, 21 is even a lot of these places disappear. So let's, for example, look at 2021. That's 2021 and that's 1992. So that sort of makes sense. That's 2013. But look there, 20, and that to some degree may also make a little bit sense. Although 2013 has got these ones, 21 excludes them as well. You see where the problem lies now. And then if we add 2024, then look at that. So if we have 1992 and that's 2024, okay, you can see there's quite a bit of difference. if we have 2013, and let's say we add now 2024, you can see this. So it doesn't make sense. There's no internal consistent thing for this. So we'll have to actually start from a point and work from it. Now, as I said, if you start from the bottom and you work up, that's fine. But if you get to a place where it's actually, we assume that we can correct it going from 1992 to 2024. My view is that we have to start from what we have in 2024 because that is a given. There's not much we can do and adjust downwards. So that's what I've done in the second video. In the second script that I've generated, I have the same color schemes, or again the five visualization parameters. I have the same masking. I have this the 1992, 2013, 2014, 2021. So I start with 2024. So the first thing that I wanted to do is I wanted to convert it from the high resolution to the low resolution. So I convert the 2024 one from 30 meters to 1,000 meters, because that's what the VIRS is, 30 meters. And so we're converting the 30 meters into, so let's just see. It doesn't show here the resolutions. No. But I'm converting it to 1,000 meters. Okay, so this is what we're doing. So we're taking the VIRS one, our VIRS, this one what we have here. So I'm taking this and I'm calling it resample. So I'm taking my VIRS, this image that we generate here, the 2024 image, this one here. And I reproject it, okay, and I reproject it for the scale. So therefore you'll see there, let me just go in a little bit, let me go in this one as well, so we can compare the two. We can compare the two. Okay, so you'll see, hey, it's still loading, it's still loading. It's not that much. Let's take these off. You can see there's the image, the VIRS image at the 30 meters spatial resolution, and there's the VIRS image at the 100 1,000 meter spatial resolution. You can see I've harmonized the resolutions. You can see the resolutions. Spatial resolution is now plus minus the same, whereas here the spatial resolution is significantly different. You can see that that's the spatial resolution with the 30 meter spatial resolution compared to the 1,000 meter spatial resolution. And I've taken that 30 meter spatial resolution and I reformulated it to a 1,000 meter spatial resolution. And now I've harmonized the spatial resolutions. So that's the good thing. So the spatial resolutions are now harmonized. So that's the first thing that I've done. Okay. So it's now done. So the whole system from 1992 till 2024 has now the same spatial resolution. Okay, and I derived that spatial resolution from the harmonized data set. Okay, so that makes sense. Okay, so what I've also done is to say, okay, I want to manipulate my 2024 image. Okay, so because as you can see here, the problem is I can harmonize the images for the harmonized data set. That I can do, okay, and that we've done by using our visualization parameters. But you can see the 2024 one looks very, very different. So as I said, step number one was to increase the spatial resolution, decrease the spatial resolution, change it, okay. But then you'll see that the VIRS numbers, if I look here, if I go and click there, if you look at the, you'll see the VIRS level is 34, which is obviously much lower than any of these values before. You can actually see that 2013 again, 43, 2013 is the outlier, so we'll have to adjust 2023, 2013, we'll have to adjust that number so that it's closer to 36. And then The average number in our average VS number is, in this case, we use the maximum number. So if we're going to use the median or medium number, that number would be much less. Because remember, in the OLS system, the numbers were almost double, sometimes three times higher, because it has this upper limit. Okay? So these numbers are. The OLS numbers in general are much higher than the VS number. The VS numbers, because it excludes the blooming and all these sort of things, are have much lower DN values than the OLS. So we need to artificially increase the 2024 number so that it harmonizes with the harmonized data set. So that's why I've used the max. Okay? So my clipping, my reducer is not the mean or the, okay, so let's quickly do the median. And then you see, so remember the average is 34. That was for, I think this one, let's just quickly make sure. Yeah, 34, that's for that block there. So let's run it again. And then I'm going to zoom in because remember that was now the maximum value. We took the maximum value. So let's quickly run through it again. Okay, so let me just, unloaded it. Yeah, I just want to get to that value there that we can use it. Same, it was, I think, this one here, that one there. So now I've used the median value. So now let's have a look. You see there, 29. So there's no way that the nighttime light profile of that location have decreased from 20, 29 to 29, from 44 to 29. That is not possible. It's not that it couldn't happen, but understanding the town, etc., etc., this is highly, highly unlikely that that is indeed what happened. So therefore, I first of all decided to use the max number. Okay, so if I use a sum, for example, let's use the sum. Okay, and see what happens. Because remember, I'm trying to get values now that represents the same values than these ones. So let's do the sum reducer, and then let's have a look and see what happens there. Okay, so let's go and see here. Let's go and see here. So let's go and press now. Okay, so now I think it's roughly this number here. So let's look at the sum. Now look at the sum, it's 78. So the mean, max, minimum values are too low, and the max value are too high, because it's also, as it went from 44 to 29, it's impossible. To go from 44 to 78 is also impossible. In fact, if we look at the max now, look at that. And if we do 2021, you see that's the 2021 nightline profile. If we go to 2024, you can see there that would suggest one massive increase in the nighttime light profile, which again, not true because here we use means and here we use the sum. So that doesn't make sense as well. So somehow we need to sort out this. So the first issue that we had to sort out was the spatial resolution. So we've sorted out the spatial resolution. The next one is to say, okay, we need to somehow harmonize these numbers, the DN values. We know that the mean is too low, the mean and the median and the max is too low, and we know the sum is too high. So what I've done is to say, okay, let's take the sum. But we're going to take the sum value and we're going to adjust it. Okay, we're going to take the sum value, meaning that's 78. Okay, and we're going to adjust it. So, and that adjustment is an artificial adjustment. We will have to have a look and see what the actual number looks like. Okay, so we're going to take 78. And we're going to multiply it by 70%. So that gives a value of 45. Okay. Now, again, it's going to be high. It should be higher than 44 in my case because I know the town is going. But whether it's 50, 45, that now we can adjust this number. We can adjust. So let's say we do that 0.6. So now I've adjusted my DN value. So let's quickly run this again. So let's quickly do that and can go in here. So again, you see the spatial resolution is amended to be harmonized with the harmonized data set. And then if I use inspector and I click here, you'll see it's going to be 10, 40, 37, 44, and 55. Now, I think that 55 is still a bit too high. So I'm going to go down 2.5 because I think it should be about, scale up to, let's make it 40%. So I'm going to use that. And let's see what that looks now. And ultimately, we want to make sure these numbers are internally consistent because that means the presentation or the images would be internally consistent as well. So let's click on that one there. 13, 43, 36, 44. Now it's 37. So that doesn't make sense. So that's now way too late. So let's go back to 60. I think you get the idea. We're going to do this now and play around with that. So let's assume that we have resolved the spatial resolution issue. And let's say we resolved the internal consistency of the numbers. Then now let's go and have a look and see. So these images should now be reflect the changes in the nighttime light profile rather than some exogenous factor. So that's 1992. That's 1993. That is 2014. Ah, sorry, man. 2013. So that's 1992. That's 2013. That's 2014. That's 2021. So that all looks fairly well, except maybe 2021. No, that looks fine. Except 2013. You see, I'm still concerned about this blooming effect in 2013. I think that's still, so we may have to address 2013 or skip 2013, go from 1992, go straight to 2014. But that's a problem because it may imply that 1992 is not correct. But and then we go to 2020. You see, between 2014 and 2021, that seems perfect. And then we go to the new 2024 and you see something doesn't make sense. Because now all of a sudden again, we have, just have a look at it. I mean, it just doesn't make sense at all. The problem is that so now we're a bit screwed because we can't increase the size of these ones because then all these areas become also visible, which should not be visible. So we want to just focus on these main towns. So this is just where it becomes very, very problematic. Otherwise, what we'll have to do is, you see, we can't increase the DN values of the previous ones. Maybe we can, yeah. But that's a problem that we run into. That's a problem that we run to. You see the minimum value there. If we increase that minimum value to, let's say, 50. See, I still have a problem with the 2013 value, which is this one here. I still have a problem with that. So if we make that 7. Okay, so now I need to make that 7. So let's have a look and see what this one looks like now. What this image looks like now. You see, okay, so that's 1992, okay? So that's fine. Then we've got 2013. Then we have 2014. See, that now like seems a little bit more plausible. So that's 2014, that's 2013. So that seems cool. Although I think 2014, we can take some 2014. Anyway, so that's cool. So that's 2021, so that's cool. So I think now from 1992, 2013, 2014, 2021, I think that seems fine. Problem is 2024. And I don't think we're going to be able to solve 2024 because what we may can do is to make this one. Let's have a look. Make this one and make this 80. And then I'm going to make this one here, because what I want to do is I'm going to increase the locations of light and decrease the intensity. And then, as I said, we have an issue with 2014. 2014, maybe we can also, so 2014 is the second one. We've already increased that. That's 2013. So let's make 2014 8. Seven, come in, 28. And then, okay, so let's maneuver those numbers and see what that looks like. So I'm trying to simultaneously increase this the size of, or the location of the nighttime lights for 2024 without and decrease the intensity. So let's have a look now what that looks like. Okay, so there's 1992, there's 2013, there's 2014, let's have a look. It looks still, I think, a little bit of a problem here. There's 2021. And then that is, you see, now the color scheme is better, but I still don't have the location, the area, you see. You see the difference there. You can clearly see. So maybe, okay, so this is now trial and error. We're going to play around with this. So maybe we're going to move that to 60 potentially. I'm going to increase that. So maybe we're going to make this multiplied by 80. And then let's keep that. Make that then 70, and then 2014, that's going to make that 10, and then 2014 we have to make that 10 as well. So let's run this one again and see what the numbers look like, and then we'll continue in a later video and see what is that look like. Okay, so that's 1992, that's 2013, 2014. So that looks a little bit better. 2021, 2024. Okay, you see 2024. See, that's, using this, I don't think we're going to be able to harmonize it because it just doesn't. I think that, yeah, it doesn't, it's not going to work. So let's make that 90 now, because we can't add numbers to these unlit areas. That's a problem, because if you go to the town here, and this is the blooming effect that you had in the old the old OLS system. So all these actually is not is the blooming effect. So what we actually then need to do is we have to minimize the locations. You see, if you do this, you see that's the 2021, and that, so these locations here, you know, we somehow need to see, if you exclude this location, that, try to exclude these rows, you're going to automatically exclude these ones as well. So again, it's not gonna work. Anyway, let's continue with this battle and see whether there's any hope, or whether this is a hopeless exercise. I think from 1992 till 2021, that's possible because that is being harmonized. But I'm just sort of adding 2024 just to show you the difficulties that we have when we're trying to harmonize the two systems, where the problems lies, and playing around with this in order to try to resolve this. But ultimately, this is quite tricky. So let's save that for now, and let's continue with this. But in this video, we showed you how to change the spatial resolution. I said you can always go from high to low spatial resolution, but going from low spatial resolution to high is very, very difficult. But yeah, so we're going to have to play around with all these tools and methods to see whether this is actually doable, whether we can harmonize these things, in what way we can harmonize this. Okay, so let me park there for now, the video. Yeah, we'll continue with this, and I'll see you on the other side.